Ideally, it is the entity in need of financing to go looking for a potential funder. However, in the new approach proposed by the Sustainable Business for Uganda platform, it will be financial institutions to take the lead in identifying the enterprises that need the financing.
Now, your country is a bigger country. You got thousands of entrepreneurs, many in the informal sector. Okay? And the space, the banks are in a comfort zone, they have a lot of money. Okay? And people keep coming to them. But now the thing is, these investors want to grow. They don't want to remain in the informal sector. They want to grow, but they want to grow beyond Uganda. They're looking to export to the EAC. They want to export to the AFCFTA countries. They want to export to EU. To do that, they must invest. They must bring money, technology, in market. And they require growth capital.
The platform is in partnership between the European Union, the government of Uganda, and the private sector foundation Uganda.
In the financing world, there is a very, very significant asymmetry, information asymmetry, in terms of the people who have the money and those who are looking for the money. I can tell you from practical experience, we don't know the people who have the money. So every time you try to look for money, then you begin to see so many potential opportunities, in as much as you may not qualify because of your level of the business, but you can begin to see the opportunity. So I think that
the other problem that comes out is that in some cases, borrowers divert the money. The money has been meant to buy a machine, but then the borrower, when you get the money, you first buy a truck, because you've been told that you can make quick money in Sudan, and then the business does not run as anticipated, and therefore you find problems paying back. So it is important for agreements when signed to be complied with.
According to a trade and investment specialist, the model has been deployed in more financially developed countries like Mauritius, and its adoption on the local market will unlock the potential of Uganda's enterprises. However, the proposed model will not give enterprises the blanket access to all the funds they require. Story by Benno Jambo for the news.